We often find ourselves wondering about expanding out our network, and you think, well, how do I go about this? And in today's video, I'm going to show you a few different ways you can link your switches together. Now in front of me I have a couple of 24 port switches that have been sent to me by sf.com, so a big thank you to them for sending this over for me and sponsoring this video. Also, they have all your networking needs covered on their website, so go ahead and check them out. I'll drop their link down in the description below. There are a number of different ways you can connect up your switches, and in this video I'm only demoing them between two switches. But if you have more than two, there are a few other alternative ways that you can connect them together. In terms of, you're able to daisy chain them, which means connecting number one to number two and then number two to number three. You also have a star-like setup for which you have a main switch, which is often referred to as a core switch, and then all your other switches are connected to this core switch. But going too much into the setup can get complicated very quickly and could require a whole video in itself. Let me just throw in that the links to the products used in this video, which I'm going to be discussing shortly, are down in the description below. If you found this video useful, do give it a like and comment down below what you think. If you feel that you want to go a step further, feel free to use the Super Thanks button or my Amazon affiliate links to buy anything from Amazon, which again are down in the description below. Back to the two switches in front of me, we have a bunch of different connectors which I'll go through shortly. These are 24 port 1 gig switches and they have four SFP plus ports that let you run through the different ways to connect them together. If you don't know, SFP stands for small form factor pluggable. If we take a look at the switch, as I mentioned, there's 24 1 gig Ethernet ports and there are four SFP plus ports. We have a console port on this switch, and we have dual power supplies on here as well. So if you want to know the model number of this is the S3900. So if you want to have a look at that, again, links are down in the description below. And it also has the username and password to access these as well. In terms of the connectors we're going to be looking at today, this is known as a DAC cable, a direct attach cable. We'll go through that one. We have some SFP plus modules, which we'll cover in a little bit more detail shortly. And then we have some fiber cables. So again, there's different types of cables for different scenarios, so we will go through them as well. So the first way we can connect the two switches together is via an Ethernet cable. And that literally means just plugging that into port one on here and plugging it into whichever port you want on here. So we'll go into port 23, for example. Now, the ports nowadays are very clever in terms of auto sensing, so they automatically know if it's an uplink or a downlink or however they've connected the switches together. They know automatically because they are auto sensing ports. Now, in terms of the speed of this, you will get 1 gigabit through this cable just here because these are 1 gig ports. However, there are options that you can link ports together. Again, I'm not going to go too much down into a rabbit hole, otherwise we'll go into one topic very specifically, but I want to keep this brief. So you can link ports together to give yourself 2 gig, 3 gig, but again, we're not going to go too much into that. Now with this cable here, you have multiple different options in terms of the cable you can use. You can use a Cat5e, a Cat6, or even a Cat6a. The maximum run of this cable between two switches to give you a gig would be 100 meters. Now this is where it gets a little bit interesting because the connections on the side of the switches are the SFP plus ports, which as I mentioned earlier stands for small form factor pluggable. Now there are different modules you can get starting from 1 gig. So you can actually get an SFP port, which is 1 gig, and this goes all the way up to 800 gig now. So now in terms of speeds, it can get pretty crazy, but I think for now, in terms of home to small business, we're seeing 10 gig become more and more available. I have four different types of SFP plus connections and they all fit into the same slot, and they're all gonna give you a 10 gig speed. First things first is the DAC cable. Now this is pretty straightforward to get this connected. There's no need to add anything into them. You literally plug one into here and one into here. They start from as little as 25 centimeters all the way up to 10 gigabytes. Generally, when you do this, you'd be stacking switches one on top of the other and you can just connect them up. So let me show you how we quickly do that. Give you a little bit more of a closer look at the DAC cable. So you can see it says 10 gig, 3 meter cable. As I mentioned, this does go all the way up to 10 meters as well. You would just take this little cap off on the front on both sides, and you would literally take this cap out just here and pop one in there. And the same on this side, you take one cap out and you pop one on there. So let's just move them out of the way. So you can see they're both connected here, and that will give you, this cable right here will give you a 10 gig connection. Next, we take a look at this packaging, which I'm generally quite impressed with. Now, these are the SFP modules that I was talking about earlier, and there's a few different options we have with this one as well. So this is quite well protected. So if you do decide to order these, they do come well protected, so there's not going to be an issue with them. We have the two fiber ones at the top, which we'll come to in a minute, but the first ones I want to have a look at are the Ethernet modules. Now, these go in exactly the same slot where we put the DAC cable in, except they have an RJ45 slot on the front. Now, we can use just a general network cable, so we go ahead and pop one of these in. You'll hear the click. And same again on this side. You'll hear the click. And we can pull back the trusty network cable and just go ahead and slot that one in there, and go ahead and slot that one in there. Now, the max that this cable will run, just like any other Ethernet cable, which will be about 100 meters, that will probably be a Cat 6A cable. The lower category you go down, the less distance you will get. Next, we have the two different fiber cables. Now, I'll show you the difference shortly, but we have a single mode. Next, we have the two different fiber options. Now, one thing you need to know is there's a single mode fiber and a multi-mode fiber. Now, again, just like the rest of this, we're not going to get down into the real technical side of this. There's loads of different videos and articles out there about what the differences are between the single mode and multi-mode fibers. I am very much simplifying this, but it's down to the cable that you're using. The core diameter inside is slightly bigger on the multi-mode option. With that in mind, it does impact the length of the run of these cables as well, so do keep that in mind. The single mode fiber will run up to 10 kilometers, and the multi-mode will run up to about 300 meters, depending on the type of cable. Just like you have the different categories for RJ45, you have the same different categories for the single mode and the multi-mode. So we have OM 1 to 5, and we have OS 1 and 2. So just keep those in mind when you are setting these up. What we have here today is an OM 5, and we have an OS 2. So we have the latest and greatest of both cables. So if I quickly pull out the single mode fiber, you can see these just here. There's a single slot on them. You do get the single mode fibers with two on them as well, so keep that one in mind. So there are, again, they break down even further depending on the type, but I'm just showing you a very high level at the moment. Pop this one straight into here. And just like this. And this is the cable that we have. This is the single mode fiber cable. Now, these can run up to 10 meters in terms of the single mode. So these are a lot more thinner, but they're also a lot more fragile. Now, to install one of these, you just need to take this little cap off and pop that straight into there, and you'll hear that click in. So it's quite straightforward. Again, take the little cap off on the end, and we pop that just in there. And to take these out, again, you just pull the little strap on, pull the little pin at the front, and that will basically just come out straight away. And lastly, we will have a look at the multi-mode fiber. So again, just like these, they have two in these. And again, they just slot straight in, just like the others. And same again, it's actually a dual cable. They're just connected together. So we take that off and we take the two pins off. And they click straight in just there. And same again with this one, we'll take that off and it clicks just in, just like that. I hope you've enjoyed this video and found it useful. If you haven't already, do hit the like button and comment down below. Hit the subscribe button if you want to join the community. I do have new videos coming out every week. For now, this is InsideWire, and I'll see you in the next one.